open up on 7. Move it out, Shiv.
Oh, I got you. Hero, huh?
Identifying prisoner 117, Shiv Helix.
You think you can break me, copper? Yeah, I've been in the darkest pits in the universe. Places that would make your bolts rattle. The eternity pits of Zord Doom. The iron holding no balance. Nah.
Greetings, new fish. I'm...
Captain Quark. I don't believe it. You're here. I used to dream of being arrested by you.
Now get out of here. I was talking to you, Zed.
Yes, Captain.
So, new fish, I take it you followed my many, many adventures?
Of course I have. You're the most famous superhero in the galaxy.
He ain't famous anymore.
Words hurt, Solitary Bill.
I'm a huge fan. I even pre-ordered the new Ratchet and Clank Holo game.
The what?
You know, the game based on that incident with you and that Lombax.
Oh, you must mean the Holo film. Yeah, it's pretty good, if you like all CG.
No, I mean the game. It's based on the Holo film. Look, here's my confirmation email. I'm having it mag shipped to prison.
They're making a game based on the Holo film based on my life? But they haven't even consulted me. Oh, this is my fault. I've been away from my adoring public in this forsaken place too long. And now, no one will ever hear my side.
I'd like to hear your side, Captain.
You would? Well, then sit down, wary criminal, and I'll tell you a story. It all started with a hapless Lombax named Ratchet.
Where do you think you're going?
Hey, Grim! You're here! I thought you'd be down at the bazaar shopping for gravity coils.
Uh-huh. Well, I'm here. I'm always here. I don't suppose you sneaking out would have anything to do with those Galactic Ranger tryouts?
I just need 1 hour. Come on, Grim. These are the Galactic Rangers we're talking about. Captain Quark will be there.
No leaving the garage until you help fix Mr. Micron's ship. Now get on that bolt crank!
Does that ship look mag-lifted to you? Get on that bolt crank, come on! Look at this thing. Avionics fried, CPU fried, even the gosh darn gravity coils fried! Okay, let's see if these new Versa bulbs work. Look up, do you see something flashing?
Yep, left side looks good.
It's a miracle. On to the afterburner lights.
Lower left afterburner light checks out.
This thing might just be space-worthy after all. One more to the...
Lower right afterburner works. So, are we good?
Yep, we're good. The news says the tryouts are being held at the fairgrounds. Show them what you got, kid.
And so, Ratchet began his adventure, hoping to become a Galactic Ranger.
Rise and shine, Kizzle Plateau. It's 8 a.m. and it's gonna be a hot one today.
Hey!
Our first story is a set loop, folks. Last night at approximately 13 our time, Planet Tenemule fell to what appears to be a Class 7 supernova. President Vironix has issued a statement calling this a tragic natural disaster. But top know-it-alls are skeptical. This is the fourth planet we've lost in the last 3 months, leaving some to wonder if there are any evil forces at play. Revered hero Captain Quark has issued a handwritten statement that reads, Donnie, can you read any of this? Looks like a bunch of scribbles of some kind of document. I'm sure it was profound. But next will be the first planet.
Ratchet bashed his enemies using his trusty Omni-Wrench.
Thank you.
order to best his foes, Ratchet used the warrior's time-honored tradition of jumping.
This behind? Friendly people, beautiful desert, all the barbecued sand toads you could ever eat. Some people don't appreciate what they have, I suppose. What's the big deal about being a Galactic Ranger anyway? Bunch of action junkies looking to prove themselves by hurling their bodies in front of incoming bullets? Tch, sounds like fool's work to me.
Knew he faced mortal peril. Should he find himself on the verge of death, he'd need to find nanotech to heal.
Oh, I used that stuff after a bank robbery once. It healed like 3 out of 5 gunshot wounds.
Displayed a flagrant disregard for public property. Look at him smashing crates. The hubris.
Maybe he was just saving up bolts so he could buy a new weapon to protect the galaxy with.
Hey, who's telling the story here? His enemies vanquished, Ratchet forged ahead. His destination?
Good work. Now keep moving to the next part of the course.
Many
of you have been asking for tips. Sage advice, if you will, from your humble galactic protector. Whenever my life is in jeopardy, I...
Good job! You could be the recruit we've been looking for. Keep moving to the next part of the course.
Hey there, recruit! I'm Brax Lectris, and my specialty is brute force. Let's see how well you can bash these crates. Man, that was pretty good. Keep moving, it's time to get our hands on some firepower. Go ahead and grab a fusion grenade glove from this Gadgetron vendor.
Take your time. You got a deal.
Awesome. Next step, blow stuff up.
The galaxy is a perilous place, as evidenced by the large amounts of ammunition left sitting around in crates. If you see me at the event, please do not run up and insist on shaking hands. My mighty vice-like grip has been known to shake the confidence of even the most heroic of men, and I would hate to throw you off your game. Spice things up. We've armed these dummies with Gadgetron flamethrowers. Our lawyers are totally cool with this.
Good job, recruit. You may just be the next Galactic Ranger. Head to the final challenge.
Come on, Ratchet. You can do this.
It's time for the final challenge. Survive a brutal onslaught of enemies, and you just might be our next Galactic Ranger. Or... down. Another one.
Whoa. Looks like some angry toads.
Impressive. Will you be looking at Solana's next Galactic Ranger? After the show.
That wasn't so bad.
Ladies and gentlemen, the savior of Solana, Captain Quark. Hello, Veldin.
Hello, Captain.
He's on fire again.
I know.
My name is Copernicus Quark, and yes, that was an impressive wall of fire I just walked past. I'm going to be real with you folks for a moment. When President Phyronix recommended I take on a new ranger, I knew just where to go. That's right. We want you!
Yeah!
I know what you're thinking. Do I have what it takes? After all, you may not have prevented Dr. Nefarious from atomizing Illyro City. You may not have stopped Neptun Prague from rendering the entire population of Iridia colorblind. Twice. After all, you may not have this chiseled jaw or godlike pectoral region, but if you have heart, then you have what it takes. You don't have what it takes.
But
I have heart.
Yes, but unfortunately that heart is encased in a weak, muscleless mass of inexperience. Plus, there's your history to consider.
Got a long line of citations here. Possession of an illegal gravity repulsor.
Operation of a black market accelerator.
Willful disruption of the space-time continuum.
That is a funny story.
You're reckless. You're a loose cannon, and you're dangerous.
That's my shtick.
Wait, just give me a chance.
All right, no time. Galaxy in jeopardy. Get back out there. And remember, you can do anything. As long as you're me. Next! Meanwhile, on planet Quartu...
Dr. Nefarious, the mad scientist who made all of this possible.
Mad suggests cognitive impairment. I'm more of a vengeful scientist. I trust you're here to meet the troops.
State your prime objective.
Destroy Galactic Rangers.
State your prime objective.
Destroy Galactic Rangers.
State your prime up.
Hello.
Defect detected. Preparing for immediate destruction. In 3, 2.
Oh, a defect. Go play, Victor.
Helpless Defect knew that his best chance for survival lay with the facility's ventilation system. If he could just run to the vent, he might just make it out of there alive.
I know you will find the Defect. You never disappoint.
Feeble Defect knew that if he were to survive, he would have to throw a bomb at whatever lay in his path. The young Defect spotted a spring bot ahead of him and knew that with this handy device in his arsenal, he could now defeat the deadliest of forces, gravity. The hopeless Defect had to throw a spring bot, but where and how?
You're running, you useless piece of scrap! Get back here and let's settle this! Warbot to Warbot! Oh no! Water!
That was a little close for my liking.
Suddenly, the Defect spotted a power bot. This device could power up a variety of machines, but where should he throw it?
You're, like, really good at adding drama, man.
Thank you, Shiv. I pride myself on my penchant for storytelling.
What seems to be the problem, Victor?
You won't get away from me, Chairman. I've got him right where I want him. You can run from me?
Not that brute again.
Get back here, you miserable defect! Try outrunning this! I'm gonna rip you apart, sprocket by sprocket. Water!
Computer, set coordinates for the Galactic Ranger home base.
Destination set. We will never make it, but hey, what are you gonna do?
Oh dear.
What? Vector shell damage. Sister board appears to be intact.
I must get to Aliro City. They are in danger.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hey, who's in danger?
An army is coming. I must warn them.
Hang on. Slow down. You've been in a crash. What do you say we get you back to my garage? I'll run a diagnostic and have you fixed up in no time.
Thank you. I appreciate the assistance.
It's no problem. So, what do I call you?
I suppose my proper designation is Warbot Defect B54296.
Maybe I'll just call you Clank. My name's Ratchet. Up and down. Yeah, there you go. You're a natural.
A million thoughts raced through Ratchet's head. Could he repair this diminutive Warbot? Would it be the key to the adventure he craved? Did he leave the proto-engine on in the garage? The answer to all these questions was yes.
All right, hang on. I'll get us back to the garage.
Large gaps were child's play to Ratchet. All he would need to get across is a trusty swing shot and a little bravado. Fortunately for our furry hero, a conveniently placed crate provided Ratchet with a combustor.
Nice! A combustor!
Ratchet basked in the freedom of being able to switch weapons whenever he felt like it.
Impressive shooting. Work.
Man, I can find it. Not far. Going down, Lombax.
Uh-oh, Bard. What are they doing here?
I have information in my databanks that poses a threat to Chairman Drek. He must have tracked my position to your planet so he could get it back.
Ratchet had to think fast. Perhaps the hookshot would solve his current conundrum.
Grim, listen to me. I want you to lock the garage doors and then head down into the shelter. I'll be there as soon as I can.
Copy that, Ratchet.
Ratchet was in a bad way. Hurt, confused, and alone. He scoured the Kizzle Plateau for signs of nanotech.
And I think that's all of them. Dropship?
Correct. Model X6Z to be exact. Also known as the Dropship of Death.
Great. Oh boy, out of ammo.
Could have given us. We gotta look for some defect.
The Blargs are all over Grim's garage. Grim, are you okay?
I'm fine, kid, but I ain't opening up till the coast is clear.
Just hold tight, Grim. I got this.
Sorry about that. Got held up on a project.
A beginner's guide to quantum burst engines.
Just throw that anywhere. I have it bookmarked.
What's this? Fun with singularities and other cataclysmic events.
That's really more for educational purposes.
It is always good to meet a fellow academic.
Really, I just look at the pictures and then, you know, wing it. Is clear. Can you open up?
Ratchet, what in Sony's name just exploded?
Sorry about that, Grim. Listen, get my tools ready. I just found something in the desert I need to look at.
Interesting. What kind of factory is this?
This? No, this is just a garage. Lived here since I was a kid. Come on, let's get you fixed up.
Once they were safe, Clank explained Drek's plan to attack the Hall of Heroes. With the Galactic Rangers out of the equation, Ratchet knew he had to help, even though neither he nor Clank had the upper body strength necessary for hero work.
I can totally help.
Oh, I could not ask a civilian to get involved in something so dangerous.
Well, no, I'm not just a civilian. The Rangers are actually my, friends. Why do you think I have so many pictures of them?
But why are you not in any of them?
Well, someone had to take the picture, right? I mean, come on. I even have a ship. It disassembles so it can infiltrate enemy strongholds. So what do you say? That's strange. I'm picking up something from Novalis.
It appears to be some sort of distress signal, but it is being jammed using a Blargian signal dampener.
The computer would have told us if we were in any real danger.
Fatal crash imminent. Would you like to record your last will and testament?
Admittedly, that's not super promising. Well, it's damaged, but I've fixed worse. Come on, maybe there's someone in town who can help us. Wait a second, is that raritanium? Maybe we should upgrade our weapons first.
Here's where you pick your weapon. Let me walk you through the process with one of mine. You're gonna need raritanium for this stuff, but we'll use some of mine for now. All you gotta do is pick one of them cells. These things chain together. Go ahead and fill out the whole chain. All right, just confirm the transaction and the deal's done. Surrounded a mystery cluster. Now that's gonna give you a big boost. That's all there is to it. Give it a spin on one of your own.
Thank you.
Hey, you looking for some weapons? Step into my office. I ain't got no office, but I might get one if I make Salesman of the Month.
Whoa, that is a lot of bad guys.
We are in the midst of a small incident. We are working hard to contact the guard so we can find a peaceful resolution. But until they return our calls, it's probably best to remain.
Youngest recruit ever to be selected for the Galactic Rangers. Oh boy.
Attention. Invading Larg, we have left you several messages regarding your invasion of this sector. I don't want to suggest this to our voice, but just in case you check your messages, there are quite a few waiting for you.
Doubt that's the last of them.
Attention, Clark! We still have not heard back regarding the transport. So I picked up the phone to make sure I have dialed them. Then I had a friend call me from a neighboring lot. Everything works on our side, so when you get a moment, give us a ring.
Oh dear, more of them.
That must be the mayor's ship.
This is a transmission for the Galactic Rangers. Please, assistance! This is Agnob Buckwash, mayor of the Cold Crater of Novalis.
Mayor Buckwash will not last long without our help. Come on. To be of assistance. Why is Dret trying to kill you?
It's my nephew, Skid McMarks.
Wait, Skid McMarks, the pro hoverboarder?
He sent me this infobot from Iridia, and the Blarg have been after me ever since. Here, take a look.
Hey, Uncle Blockwash! Skid McMarks here. You know, your nephew. My agent and I are at the awesome grand opening of the McMarks Sports Shack here on Iridia, and boy, has this been a trip. I've gotten to meet all kinds of people. Fans, celebrities, my Gadgetron sponsors. I even got to sign autographs for these odd-looking creatures called the Blarg. I guess they're doing something here on Iridia. Wait, hold on a second. Hydro Harvester, super illegal water displacement apparatus. I don't think I was supposed to have this.
Stop him! He's got the schematics!
Help! Someone! Call my agent! Call my publicist! Actually, don't call either of those people. Call someone who cares about me! I don't want to die!
Sounds like Skid McMarks is in trouble. We gotta get to Iridia.
Agreed. But we must first repair our ship.
Right. Okay, let's see if we can find some help.
Attention, citizens! Your mayor is safe and sound. I was rescued by a furry hero and his robot friend. I will now... I'll resume regular office hours, which is every third Tuesday from 10 to 10:30.
Seriously, what's with all the jumping?
Chairman Dread.
boy. Out of ammo.
Darn blood, you jammed the transmission! Who's gonna save us now? Oh, hello there. I'm glad you're here. I've been... Hey, have we met before? Because I'm getting a touch of the old deja vu.
I don't think so.
Huh. Well, guess the old think tank could use a good plumbing. Anywho, I've been trying to get a distress call to the Galactic Rangers ever since Drax forces showed up.
This entire region is overrun with Blargian dropships. We need to get you out of here.
Well, I can't go anywhere until I get this here info bot into the hands of Captain Quark.
We were on our way to speak with him when our ship was shot down. Perhaps we could take a look.
Oh, sure thing. I swabbed it from one of those Blarg soldiers. Here you go.
Oh, hello there. I'm Alonzo Drek, chairman of Drek Industries. Many of you may be wondering, why are 300 heavily armed warbots marching ominously towards a Class G dreadship? The answer is simple, friends. Progress. Years ago, we were driven underground by pollution that may or may not, but most definitely was, caused by my father's company. Since then, we've shifted focus from robotics to planet building. Now that our project is nearing completion, we must do everything possible to stay on schedule. In this case, it means our friendly army of warbots must vanquish those who would seek to stop us. Good news? They don't know we're coming! So sit back, relax, and take comfort in the knowledge that Drek Industries is working for you!
Drek Industries is not working for you.
I see you're having a little transportation trouble. Why don't I meet you by your ship? We'll get you squared away and ready to fly.
Did that guy just slide down a sewer pipe? Well, it does look like the fastest way down. Let's give it a shot. Want to do it again?
Okay, let's see what we got here.
And so, Ratchet and Clank set out to fix their ship with the help of the plumber. Little did they know they would soon come so close to greatness, they'd be able to hear its mighty biceps ripple. But first, they'd have to tackle a brain-eating zombie T-Rex.
Hey, wait a minute. I don't recall no brain-eating zombie T-Rex.
Okay, fine. Killjoy.
Well, you look about all fixed up here. Now promise me you'll get that infobot to Captain Quark.
I promise. Thanks for your help.
No problem. See you in the next reboot.